Hello students, very good morning. So today let's continue our portion that we had studying yesterday. So here in yesterday class we have discussed the theory of interference and YDSC experiment. So here in the theory of interference, first we had to find out what is the path difference between the two waves that are reaching at this point P, because this A point is already of maximum intensity, so here constructive interference will always obtain because delta is equal to 0 here. So for path difference that is 0, we will always obtain maximum intensity. So this will be always of maximum intensity. But P point will be maximum or minimum according to our conditions of path difference. So the path difference between two waves is S2P minus S1P. So in the last class we have calculated this is S2P minus fringe width. Means what is the distance between two bright fringe? yn minus 1, that is n lambda d by small d minus of n minus 1 lambda d by small d. Now if you will solve it, n lambda d will be cancelled out, you can obtain lambda d by d. Means you can see this is constant. So all the right points are separated by a distance lambda d by d to each other. They are equally distantly separated. There is no difference between their fringe width. Means if first fringe is obtained here, then at the equal distance, equal separation you will obtain for all the bright fringes. So this is, I think, now clear. If we will impose the maximum condition, what is the distance at which you will find, just to find out the maximum intensity, exactly the location of point you can calculate from here. You can directly see that point is maximum point or not in your experiment. And here you can see the separation means the first maxima you have obtained. You can directly add this separation to obtain the location of second maxima. Don't need to write again the value of this one. You don't have to calculate this. Directly calculate this one, because every separation is, for example, we have seen this is constant. Means if you will add just v time first one, it will directly provide you y2. So let's see that beta has value lambda d by d. So this will be equal to 2 lambda d by d. You can see now. Again, if you will just add here beta again, this will provide you the value of y3, 3 lambda d by d. In the same way, you can calculate all the distances. So this is very easy method to understand the location of the right or dark points in this space. Now next one, after the maxima condition, let's see if this point P is of minimum intensity, then what will be the distance of this point from the center maxima point from A. So second for the minima, for minima we have a condition delta is equal to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2, means odd multiple of lambda by 2. And now we have the value of delta, that is yd upon capital D. This is 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. We can calculate y from here, so that is equal to 2n minus 1 lambda d upon 2d. And if we will just write here, and this will denote the general condition again, just like the right fringes. So we can now plot the value of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So n is equal to 1, if you will put, it will provide you the distance of first dark point or first minimum intensity point. So y1 is obtained from this one, you will put n is equal to 1. So this is 2 minus 1, 1 it will be lambda d upon 2d distance. This is the distance of first bright point from the point A. Next one, you can find out the second point's distance. You have to put n is equal to 2 here, so that is y2 now. So this is n is equal to 2 means 4 minus 1. So this is d of lambda d upon 2d. So 3 by 2 lambda d by d. This we will call. In the same manner, you can obtain third right point, fourth right point distance from the point A here. So now we can again find out the separation of the fringes, just like we have got for the right fringes. So that separation again it is represented by beta. So this can be simply done by y2 minus y1, or you can also done it by yn minus 1. See that by yourself, its value is again obtained as lambda d upon d. This is the same value as we have got for the fringe separation in the case of maximum intensity points. So it means that you can say in interference pattern, all the maxima, minima, all strips are equally distanced, equally spaced. Simple. Means the distance between two maxima or two minima are equal, that is equal to lambda d by d. Or they are, you can say they are equally spaced, that's why this distance is equal there. So separation between fringes and this spacing of fringes, both are now equal here in this case. And this was all of the theory of intercurrence that we had to understand here, that is fringe width and the condition of the finding location of this point P, if it is dark or if it is bright. These two things are being now clear. Now the next topic, let's see what will be if we will introduce a plate of thickness T in the path of, or any thin plate one wave. Means here you can see the two waves that are going and that are interfering. If we have just kept a plate, a very transparent glass plate, you can take this just put here, observe the things, then what will be now the condition of point at point P? So here experimentally it has seen that whenever we are introducing some of the plate in the path of any one of the interfering beam, then that time an additional path difference of lambda by 2 is created. Means we can have now additional path difference in the conditions that we have seen. So let's see now the introduction of plate in the path of interfering beam. You can multiply this one, you can solve. So this is now condition of interference, not that one. is again odd multiple of lambda by 2, but this time this will not be 2n minus 1, this will be 2n plus 1. So 2n plus 1 lambda by 2, just put it here. This is called a maximum when we are introducing some of the plate in the path of the one of the interfering beam. Now next one, we will again write out the condition for minima. So this will be equal to delta plus lambda by 2, and delta for minima is equal to odd multiple of lambda by 2, and this is lambda by 2, and if you will just solve it, so this is 2n into lambda by 2 minus of lambda by 2 plus of lambda by 2, these are cancelled out, and 2 will be cancelled out, you will obtain I lambda. So here in this case you can see this is the condition for the minima or the dark point in this case. Means our condition is totally inverted now. In the previous condition, it was the condition of minima, it was the condition of maxima, but now it is the condition of maxima and minima. So whenever the plate is introduced, our whole of the theory or the point, you can say now that is shifted. Because without shifting, you cannot get in the place of minima, you are obtaining now maxima. Because this was the condition of minima, but you are now obtaining a maxima here. So your minima is shifted now. So this is called the lateral shifting of the fringes. So whenever we are introducing some of the plate, then lateral shift of fringe occur. That lateral shift you can calculate easily by just taking the difference of the two fringes here. In this case, maxima and minima difference is C, and that is equal to the fringe shift. So this concept is now here. This is the additional concept that is very important before starting the new topic, that is diffraction of light. So let's see the next topic, that is diffraction of light. So diffraction of light. So what is the diffraction? If literal meaning of diffraction you will see, that is bending of light. So only in a general form you can say whenever the light is bending at the edge of the source, that is known as diffraction of light. Like you have seen, so if we are in dark room, then if some of the hole is present in that room and light is coming from that hole, then you can see light is going to diverge. This at the edge of the hole, if you can see, light is bending. So the bending of this one property is known as the diffraction condition. And if I will say it in some general and extended way, so diffraction is a way of interference in which we are obtaining the additional phase difference of light. Like as just now I have told you a special case when some of the plate is introduced in one of the path of the interfering beam. So here we can see due to the introduction of the plate, what was exactly the condition? The light will feel refraction there in that plate, and you know in refraction light beam either it will bend or it will go away from the normal. So first when it is going from like this is our source, so this is our slits, this is first source S1, this is second source S2, this is our now screen. So light is going from here to here, and one of the light is going, suppose I have just put here glass plate of thickness T. So in these both light beams, first when light beam will enter here at the surface when it will fall, so as it is going for surface, it is going from air to glass. So for air to glass, it is going from rarer to denser media. So in denser media, it will bend towards the normal. So you can draw here normal to this one and that will bend. So after bending, again it will go away from the normal. So if it is like it is bending in this way, and then it is go away again, so it will go away, but you can see now the path of the light that will change here due to the refraction of light. So here due to the changing path, obviously there will be the path difference that is traveled by the wave that will be changed here. So due to change in path difference, the interference pattern is property changing. So diffraction is a type of interference in which the light gets bended first, after that it is interfering and it is providing us the pattern of the interference, that is known as diffraction pattern. Although you can understand it by the same manner as we are introducing the plate here. So in the same manner, whenever some of the edges are present, so on with travel additional path, and that additional path is equal to lambda by 2, and that behavior is just like same as the plate. So the ideal first of all direction is not here. Simple bending of beam at the ends of the any source from the corners of the source, that is known as direction of light. Now in the case of direction of light, first let's see what are the conditions for the direction here. So conditions for the diffraction, that is first of all the condition of interference will be satisfied here. Like for interference of beam, we have first condition sources should be coherent, second condition frequencies should be exactly equal, third condition the amplitude of the wave should be nearly equal, next condition like this, the distance between source and screen should be large, distance between sources should be small. So these kind of conditions that we have discussed before, light should be monochromatic at all these conditions are automatically satisfied in diffraction, because I am telling you diffraction is a type of interference in which light gets bended from the edges, means whenever some of the obstacle is put in between the motion of the light, in between the path of the light, the light get bended. And due to the bending of light, we are obtaining some additional path difference of lambda by 2. That is called the diffraction of light. So bending means I am saying you, some of the obstacle you are putting in the path of the light wave exactly. So that is now the diffraction. I think that is now clear. Next one, additional some of the things we need here to get the diffraction pattern. So that additional conditions are here. First of all, the wavelength of light. That should be order of the separation between the molecules of the obstacle that we have used. Means you can obtain only diffraction pattern with the help of those obstacles, those plates in which the molecular separation or interatomic separation or ionic separation, whatever they have. So that separation is the order of the wavelength of the light. In that condition only, or if it is less than the wavelength of light, then we can observe that conditions of the diffraction pattern, means bending of light will be there, and this condition we are observing. So here why we need to study it, actually this property, that condition I am saying you, this is used a lot to understand the crystal structure, a lot of structures, like we are using to study the crystal structure. Solids are of two types, amorphous solid, crystalline solid. The crystalline solids we are using to study them X-ray light. So as X-ray has the wavelength comparable to the interatomic separation in crystals, some of the crystals are even studied by the infrared. So here whatever the wavelength is suitable for their interatomic or intermolecular separation, that we are using. So we need to keep the knowledge of diffraction here to understand it. I think that is now clear, completely clear. So after diffraction, let's see first the conditions of diffraction. Here, as that in diffraction we are also observing interference, then for interference there should be a conditions for maxima or minima. So let's see now the maxima and minima condition in interference of light. So in the conditions of maxima, suppose for first one I am saying for the constructive diffraction or for the maxima. So any point in diffraction pattern that will be of maximum intensity if its path difference is equal to n lambda, if we are talking for the interference, and if we are talking for the diffraction, means we have put some of the obstacle in path of the wave, so that wave is bended, it has to travel additional path, and that path, additional path that is traveled due to bending of wave is calculated as lambda by 2. So here the path difference of the wave for the diffraction of light to get maxima should be this one. So this lambda by 2 path difference is obtained only due to additional travel of light in due to the obstacle that we have put. Without obstacle there is no diffraction, that will be interference. So that time this one will not occur, only this condition will be there. But with obstacle this condition will be clear. So we will get now 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 finding the situation for this one. Now in the same manner here maximum intensity. Second one you will see for minima. So for the minimum intensity, if we will see now that the interference condition for minimum intensity for sweat side, that is equal to 12 minus 1 lambda by 2. This is odd multiple of lambda by 2 is condition for the minimum intensity in the case of diffraction of light. And here, due to the obstacle as diffraction is obtained, then we have to add lambda by 2 here also. So due to the induction of obstacle, due to the bending of light, additional path difference lambda by 2 will be traveled by the wave, and that's why this is now condition of diffraction here, that is equal to lambda by 2 minus of lambda by 2 plus of lambda by 2. This is now 0. And this will be equal to 2 and 2 cancel out. Finally, we are obtaining lambda. So this is now the condition for diffraction to get minimum intensity, where n can take values 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So again, here one more thing you can see by this calculation. For n is equal to 0, we are observing maximum intensity, means always the central point that will be of maximum intensity. The reason there, as the to reach the central point, the in interference pattern there is no path difference. Here, if you will put n is equal to 0, all the lambda by 2 you will obtain, and this lambda by 2 is due to the introduction of obstacle in the path. So that's why in this way we are always obtaining the maximum condition as like same as we were obtaining for the interference of light. So students, I think the maximum minimum condition for diffraction of light, that is totally now clear. And what are the now, let's see, what are the difference between diffraction and interference. After that, we will move further in some of the experiment with diffraction of light. And here, just like the Young's double slit experiment, we can see here the single slit experiment. So, single slit diffraction, we will see better. So, here the topic, that is difference between diffraction and. So, the first difference is here, that is the interference of light is obtained by the interference or superposition of two coherent sources or two coherent waves. Diffraction of light is obtained as the interference of two coherent waves when one light is bended from some of the obstacle that is put in path of that one. The next one difference is here for the maxima. In the case of interference, the condition is delta is equal to n lambda. Where in the case of diffraction, for maxima the condition is 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. Means in this case it is even multiple of lambda by 2, but in this it is odd multiple of lambda by 2. Third one condition is here, our difference is here for the minima. In interference pattern we are observing in odd multiple of lambda by 2, and here we are observing 2n lambda by 2 or n lambda here simple. So these are the basic difference. Next one here, in the case of interference, there is no bending of light, only means no additional path difference is created. But in the case of diffraction, whenever diffraction is obtaining, there should be some of the obstacle in the, through which light can be bended. So there is needed to put some of the obstacle in the path of light there. That is our compulsory situation. So I think now, so student, as rest of the things we have discussed about the diffraction and interference, what are the differences. So let's today end our class here by with the help of this discussion. Rest of the things let's discuss in the next class. So in next class we will see what is single slit diffraction experiment and what are the necessary conditions for the single slit, that is what are maxima and minima conditions in single slit, and what is first of all single slit, how the diffraction is obtained in that all cases. So I think student, first of all, interference is very clear to you. Revise the topic of interference, because to understand diffraction you need to first understand the interference, and then you can just understand it one, because diffraction is a type of interference. So before that one you have to just understand the types here. So let's end our class here for today, guys. Thank you.